Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Dedicated to all the alumni who had died in World War I, we're in Darrell K. Royal Memorial Stadium, and that'll be the playing field for today's game. Harris has the ball teed up, and we're just about ready to get this one started.
He sends this one deep. He's to the 20.
He's tackled
at the 23.
The Longhorns right now, Kirk, I think they've just got to play within themselves. Sometimes you get at home and you get just a little bit too fired up at the beginning of a game.
I agree with you. I think sometimes there's a tendency for certain teams to press a little bit because they're trying so hard to keep this home crowd in the game, and they've been waiting all week and they're so excited. Sometimes you force a play. Let's let the play naturally come to you and react to it. So we'll see if this team playing at home jumps the gun a little bit, or if they just let the game come to them.
The Longhorns always have guys that are near the top statistically, and that's no exception today. We're really looking forward to watching this kid play.
From their own 21-yard line, second down.
Mike, 51.
Let's go, D.
He's out to the 30. He's taken down at the 38.
Just a simple draw play there, but they picked up some big yards.
Short over the middle.
That's a great tackle at the 47.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
Around the 32-yard line.
You talk about a dual-threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground. Receiver pass the sticks and get in the ball. That was a great throw.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. Let's it fly. From the 18-yard line, second down. Tackles right around the 20. From the 20-yard line, it's third down. He throws it. This one is incomplete.
These guys just don't seem to be on the same page, and they're going to have to be if they expect to win this game.
All right, D, let's go. All right, D.
Hey, Mike 51, Mike 51.
Got a man. Watch out here. He gets hit out of bounds at the 3.
Running, the blocking, the entire package. A well-deserved score.
He splits the uprights with the extra point.
Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
The Demon Deacons came into the game ranked ninth. After the bitterly disappointing loss, how far will the pollsters move them down? And for Western Michigan, they've won two straight. The Broncos roll by 19.
Thanks, Reese. 7-0 game here. Pino, ready to kick. He's to the 20. Brought down to the 28-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. They get nice yardage on that run.
That'll make it 77.
Another run. Tackled outside after a nice pickup.
That's a gain of 7 on the play. First down.
From their own 39-yard line, it's first down. Some open field. Good outside run there.
That brings him second and five.
Quickly to the tight end, incomplete. From their own 44-yard line, third down. The Buckeyes saw one of their top players going down earlier, but it looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. He gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
Kirk, you and I have talked to the coaches. We've talked to his teammates. Everybody says this kid's a real deal. We're about ready to find out.
Here's a running play. He's on the run. Knocked out of bounds around the 25-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
He's in trouble.
Sutton comes away with 5 yards on the scramble there. I don't know if they'll be able to hear his cadence in the midst of all this mayhem. Deep ball, laying it out there. Oh my, what a catch. Touchdown. The extra point to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. A 9-play, 71-yard drive. And they come away with a touchdown. We get a tie game at 7-7. Ohio State lines up for the kickoff. He'll return it from the one. Tackle made at the 28.
I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. And I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning where they start to get a little bit fatigued.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
Nice run to the outside.
Ready.
they complete that for about 7 yards, and they'll pick up a first down.
Nice protection, a good pass, and even a better catch. You can't ask for much more than that.
Gets it out complete again to his tight end. And they push him out at the 36.
That brings in second and nine.
Go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. Tackle at the 24-yard line. Gets it out quickly. He's knocked out of bounds at the 15. Second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. The 10. Nice run there as they work the outside. We've played one quarter. We're even at 7 in this one. Set to resume action here in quarter number 2. Deadlocked after the first 15 minutes.
Let's go one more.
Brought down at about the 11.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
This is the 9th play of this drive. At the 6-yard line.
That makes us third and goal.
Man left, man left. Pull down, pull down. Mike 51, Mike 51. He's coming, he's coming, he's coming.
End zone, touchdown. And did that play ever develop nicely?
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
And it takes some real accuracy on those deep corner routes. So kudos to the quarterback. And he converts the extra point. A 10-play, 72-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out soon.
Texas gets set to kick this one away. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
This is my kind of game. We're getting a chance to see so many touchdowns. I just wonder if this offense could continue the flow that we've seen from the previous 3 series.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Darby on the run. Tackle made at the 41.
Gain of 16 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
After a decent pickup.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That brings him second and 5.
And he's taken down at the 42. Down now, and they need to get it inside the 49. The intimidation factor is definitely here when you're playing in this stadium. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off.
receive. And he's taken down at the 32-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Texas is up a score. And they make the stop at about the 35. Complete. He's got room to work. And he tackles him hard at the 44-yard line. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
He knew it was a run all the way. Got a good jump. Once he got there, he wasn't about to let him slip away either.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 41-yard line.
Let's go, man.
Throws complete, big loss. They lose four there.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Stop there on third and long, and that's going to bring up a punting situation.
This is a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
Parsons awaiting the return. Oh, excellent punt. And down he goes at the 21-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Gains his way to the 29-yard line.
A nice job by the offensive line, and they pick up a gain of eight.
Ohio State's going to take their first time out of the half.
And there's 2 minutes remaining in the half.
Open field. He's taken down right around the 34.
First down.
And he's tackled right away.
That makes it second and two.
He's on the run. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. And down he goes at the 48-yard line.
Gain 10 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Tight end right. Tight end right. Four down.
Mike 50.
And he throws it away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 48-yard line.
He's going to go for the home run. Intercepted. It's the junior corner. And he is drilled at the 13.
It's a good play when the corner can break up a pass, but it's even better when he can bring it in for an interception.
Texas is up 7.
Going deep, lays it out there.
That makes it second and ten.
They line up at the 13. Second down.
Our time. It's our time. Mike 51. Mike 51.
Let's go.
There's a strike complete. He's down. Makes it out to about the 29. And he's going to lose big yardage. He's tackled immediately after the catch. They're stopped for a 5-yard loss.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
Second and long. Ball on their own 24.
Roger, Roger.
We've played a half of football. Texas leads 14-7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow. Just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is, and it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground, and which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right, you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. The Longhorns continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He's tackled at about the 19-yard line. Side. He's out to the 30. They'll bring him down at the 35-yard line. He makes it to the 38-yard line. To maybe the 40-yard line. From their own 40-yard line, third down. You expect this every time you're here, and you're never disappointed. This crowd is amazing. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's about 4 yards on the play. The Buckeyes running back taken out earlier, sidelined with that injury. However, it looks like he's going to be able to come back in this game. Harris is the punter. Booming kick. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Texas is up by a touchdown. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers.
Here we go. 180.
Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
Accuracy is such a vital part of being a quarterback. You've got to have an ability to lay the ball right into your guy's hands.
Man left, man left. Four down. Hey, watch 11. Here we go. 180.
It's caught, first down, and he's out of bounds. Makes it out to about the 50.
That's good for Dylan. That makes it second and two.
Tackled around the 29-yard line. They come out on an empty backfield. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Texas up 7 points. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. From the 17-yard line. First down. Tackle at the 17.
No gain on the play. That brings up second and nine.
Gets out to around the 6. Touchdown, Texas! Great play by the halfback there to find his way into the end zone.
Again, the offense goes with the option. The defender can only pick one player. And this time, he can't pick the wrong guy.
The extra point. Reese Davis is standing by with this update. Reese?
Checking in on some ACC action, the Volunteers' rushing attack can be difficult to stop when they get into the end zone for a touchdown. Tennessee leads it 14-0.
And for the Longhorns, well, these players know now that they can move up with the polls if they win this game and if that score holds. They line up to kick this one away. Taken at the 5. And he's tackled at the 30. Their last drive broke down and they punted. What do they have in store this time out?
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Takes the ball right. Tackled outside after a nice pickup.
Darby
gains around 6 yards on the run.
That'll make it 7-4.
Pitches in, and he's got a lane.
He's at midfield. He gets out to about the 44-yard line.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
Mike's 50, Mike's 50.
Brought down around the 35-yard line.
That brings him second and nine.
He gets another carry. Tackled for a loss. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Really one of the very tough places to play in college football, and it's no different today. They go to the left for a nice gain.
Gain of 6 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Runs it and tackled in the backfield. Loss of two on the run by the halfback. Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 32. The Buckeyes running back down there on the sideline. He was injured earlier. He means a lot to this offense, but I think he's going to be able to come back in. Looks like he's ready to go. Makes it out to about the 19.
First down.
Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
Gain 15 on the play. That makes it first and goal.
Larry. Rush 50. I got it.
And as he threw it and it's caught. Touchdown. Converts the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. McFadden from the 2. Tackle made at the 18. Both these offenses stepping up and answering the bell. Who's going to blink first here?
Exactly right. I've just been impressed with the way they've been able to execute. I mean, there's a lot of pressure on them. Anytime you're feeling that the other offense can put points up on the board, there's a tendency to want to press. Neither one has done that up to this point, and right now it's going to come down to who can continue to execute, put points up.
End of the third, and we've got a tight one. The Longhorns with a touchdown lead. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. This is a pretty crucial series right here. Things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Nice run there. Texas is up a score. He's taken down at the 23.
I like how the defense got all up into that option to disrupt it. The offense looks a bit unsettled after losing that battle.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down.
Mike 51.
On the throw, incomplete pass.
Well, that is great coverage by this defense. They did everything that they could to force that wide receiver into a very small window close to the boundary. The quarterback makes the throw to give his receiver a chance to make a play. The problem is there's no room left for the receiver to get his foot down for the catch.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. Parsons fields at the 30. He's tackled at the 40.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Tackle made at the 35.
That makes it 7-15.
From their own 35-yard line, it's second down. He scrambles. Now he's going to run and watch out. And they make the stop at midfield.
Call it a gain of 15 yards. First down.
Watch the run. Watch the run. Watch the run.
Makes it to the 41. The delay gave the back some room to run, and he was able to pick up about 9 yards.
Second and one.
Taken down around the 39-yard line. So he found his receiver for the first down.
Well, they got to him in a hurry, but it was just a little bit too late. That's a nice first down pass.
Got his man. Oh, what a hit.
Number 20 makes the tackle at the 32-yard line. That'll bring up second and three.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. Quick throw, and he's got his man again. And down he goes at the 30-yard line. It's arguably the loudest crowd in the nation, and they are turning it up a notch. Here's the handoff, and he's brought down right away. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. And they got him for a loss. The offense couldn't convert, and that's going to cost him the possession.
This time the offense isn't successful on fourth down. The defense had that option play snuffed out from the get-go.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way.
Out to around the 45. Ohio State just took their first time out. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. They'll spread the field with five wide. And he's immediately tackled. Mackey picks up around 5 yards with that catch.
And I like the decision the quarterback made on this play. He didn't try to force a deep pass. Instead, he just threw a little dump-off pass that was good enough for a first down.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. Tucker gets around three on that option keeper. Ohio State's out of timeouts. From the 47-yard line, it's second down. A great tackle at the 44-yard line.
That'll make it 35.
A little over a minute in the game. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Well, that's a great job by this offense. The defense knew that the run was coming, and they still could not slow them down. Pick up a first down and allows him to continue to work this clock.
First and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's a deep seven. 7-3.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee. And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, 21-14, Texas. EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. This is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.